Oke okay guys, match penentuan Bren versus Onyx.
Okay, now you're going to be looking for maybe a Roamer, maybe a Rupee actually for AP Bren because it can check the waves. Minotaur is also open. There's also a valid hero going up against Eevee. I mean, you don't get some real world motivation, but at the same time, you stop him from doing it.
Well, the Keyboy. They go Edith and the Khalid. Keyboy
Will it be Harith? But that might be an overload of magic damage.
Yeah.
So they might just go standard. Go for Claude.
Yeah, go for standard, man. This is game 7.
Game 7.
You don't want to leave it up to chance. If they do pick up the Harith, then again, keeping their ace in their sleeve.
Bruno or Claude.
Yeah. Bruno or Claude, definitely.
I think Bruno, more consistent damage. Claude can do the same thing, technically, with a lot of pressure there. They have already, but...
Ooh, Claude.
CW is feeling an after
performance
in the previous game.
What did he do? He went in their base and he said, fight me. Fight CW. He took that fight. He got that wipeout. I mean, at this point, you got the momentum. Don't stop. This is for the world championship.
And the thing is, if you're looking at to compare both of the lineups, we know for sure that this pro decomposition from AP Bren is very strong at the early to the mid game. Come late game though, Deceive with the Claude, and then you have the Kadita factor. It's gonna be hard to control the map. AP Bren, they might win this best of 7. They should
win
their standard playstyle. Their early game.
To everyone tuning in, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the last game of the M5 World Championship, where either the Golden Throne will be completed or the World Tour be completed. We're jumping into the game where this game will determine the World Champions.
There's no other way to see it happen. One last time. Rizal Memorial Coliseum, give it up for the two teams.
Now, Keyboy as well as Ogwen, man-to-man defense, looking at each other here. Looks like this time maybe Bren is opting not to go aggressive into the jungle. Kyrie, for once, will have an easier time farming up to level 4.
CW have to go for the Purify, knowing that he can be gone upon by Ogwen. And obviously, FlapTZ can go for the Flicker place, we know. I can eliminate the Goldaner easily. So Wind of Nature might be rushed here by CW. Maybe his third item, or maybe fourth.
Okay. Some damage placed down. Quick Sand Guard gets him. A bit more HP. Kyrie already looking for an invade. Kaltz is able to clear it out. Just a big one, though. Kyrie looking for a little small one. Retrieves it. Gets level 4. And pokes Kaltz, getting more prio in the bottom lane.
And again, we got to look at how Sonic Keyboy. I got to say this. Duo has been doing well for Onyx, but the same can be said for Few as well as Ogwen. I do feel like with the composition that they both have, the mid duo is going to be a very big impact in this game.
Speaking of the mid duo here for Keyboy as well as Sans, it's a tricky duo because you clear the waves fast, but you don't necessarily stay in that lane. It's going to be up to Onyx on how they utilize this Keyboy Kadita. And at the same time, AP Bren, they don't have the best heroes to kind of check the bushes. Maybe Kaltz could be there, but of course Few can save his teammates, but they're not built for this Kadita.
Few able to pull them in, but not that much damage. Both Sans as well as Boost just want that level 4. Kaltz already leashing the turtle in a position where he can cancel at any moment. Kyrie thinks about it.
We'll get the first turtle.
Doing the same thing. Kyrie with a shield unity into the back right now, able to connect it onto Ogwen, who has the and now the onward.
Oh yeah, definitely AP Bren won the turtle, won the fight. This is the usual story of this best of 7. Look at AP Bren to win the early.
Yes. It's the early game for AP Bren all the time. They're the masters of the early game that we saw all throughout this MVP.
Come on, guy.
Every time that they win, they destroy their enemies in the early stages. And you gotta say, FlapTZ started the charge once again, going in for the flicker play. In fact, they have Pope Sands, Sans forced to use the flicker and the real world manipulation to try to keep himself alive. But in the end, during the turtle fight, he was a non-factor. And it's all thanks to Flap Cheesy.
Yep, now, looking at the item builds here, the Claude has to delay a little bit just because he has to build a little bit of defense. But Boots getting attacked here. Look at that.
Oh,
my goodness. The Ghostbusters as well.
Boots, Boots. No, I don't Boots. Oh, thank you.
Popped down by Sans Ogwin. Just posturing, zoning Boots away. Meanwhile, looks like CW wants to farm up safely here. And again, Onyx, they have to find a way to slow down a game while AB Brand has to figure out how to get these objectives, because they've been getting the kills. They got the turtle. The faster they can get the outer turrets, the more space they're going to deny from Keyboy.
However, few with two assists and a lot of late prio. Able to get to level 6. It's actually almost a level ahead of Suns. Going to be waiting for that. That's a massive lead that AB Brand has. More resources, more EXP means that in the early stages of the game, yeah, surely they have the advantage to make a team fight. And eventually, they will activate Super Marco. Fortunately for Onyx, the turtle is onto the bottom lane where it means that they might not suffer from the Brody, but all the same, Onyx, they don't have the best tools to go up against AB Brand anyways.
Yep, and now we're looking at a turtle. Kyle Teezy initiated. Kyrie finds Flap. The Flap just wants to wait a little bit of time. He sees signs, pokes him down. There's a good amount of damage. Kyle Teezy as well there. Both junglers at level 7. Flap on a turtle. No quick sand guard this time around. Kyrie picks up the gold buff. Meanwhile, up top, there's also a little bit of a gank.
Oh,
going to be caught. Taken down. Kyrie versus Flap versus Kyle. And it's Flap.
And
Kyrie brought back to the team by the Shadow Stampede. The And that is a trade. One kill up top for a turtle for AP Brent. Kyrie is one of the only junglers that can play a utility hero like an assassin.
How the hell did he turn the needle? He gets out and into safety. Unfortunately, still missed the retribution. So, still massive coming up from AP Brand. Almost a free turtle, if you think about it, because they didn't lose anything. At the same time, Onyx had to just back.
Ini live comment-nya bilang Kyrie impostor,
guys.
Oh no. Nice. Wow. Nice, tes, cewek bagus, bagus, bagus. Wow, Keyboy. One. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Seru banget, seru, seru banget, seru banget.
That's a positive trait, obviously, for Onyx, as they switch back and lead toward their side. They give two assists to see the one kill after that. Eventually, he died, but that's all good for the...
GG. Kelas, kelas.
...farm in this early stage of the game.
Apakah... We will bring back trophy, guys.
I just want to say, man, this time they're picking up the pace. Both teams are fighting. I would say in a faster tempo here, both teams are finding the mistakes, and this is what happens in the best of seven. Keyboy, I gotta say, very counter engaged. Coming in from AB Brand is like AB Brand, it strikes, but then Keyboy is just like, I'm just waiting for you guys to clump up.
And he
want to deal maximum damage.
Look at his position right now. He's trying to pin down Super Marco without the flicker. He does have the petrify. Super Marco not feeling so confident walking towards that bush. That's a smart decision on his part.
I mean, at this point, he doesn't want to get wet, man. Like, he smells something, and he's like, I'm smelling a fish. Kyrie smelling an engage. Flap Teezy jumps forward, a petrify. He knocks Flap Teezy out, but he's still able to get out in time. The quick sand card buys him a little bit more time. CW able to bat away with a battle mirror image, but he did just bait out a raging sandstorm and a quick sand card.
That's good enough, because me, Sans can pop the ultimate this time.
No petrify this time, though, for Keyboy.
Semoga nggak ada pause-pause lagi ya, guys. Oh, perfect turtle by Happy Brand.
Looks like Onyx, they just want to get some kills. They don't really want to contest with the turtle, because we saw that they are basically avoiding the turtle. They just want to go in. They want to get Super Marco down. Because Super Marco, like, has to use the rough ways to escape.
Okay, ada wall, ada wall. Ayo, Boots.
Retribution, he steals it. AP Brand are making micro moves that eventually pile up, and now it's great macro from AP Brand. They have regained the lead because of the small things that they have done, and they are doing it cleanly.
Oh yeah, very clean right now. Onyx, it looks like they're being more responsive than being proactive. Whatever AP Brand is doing, they want to counter it for better or for worse. And AP Brand, I kind of feel like they're starting to understand the mentality coming in from Onyx. So if you guys are waiting for us to make a move, well, we're gonna give you the sleight of hand. We're gonna show you the left side while we take something from the right.
Brody is up top. That means Onyx might go for the push here. But Flap Tizzy ever so on point with the defense. And AP Bren are just denying everything away from Onyx. Onyx just can't catch a break.
Everyone is on one side of the map.
Sounds now Oh no, sad.
And the thing is, the Lord was already respawning during that time, so every single move that Onyx did in that fight is a mistake. And AP Brand punishes with the Lord take.
Right now, AP Brand 3,000.
Seven! There is absolutely no way we can end
they might try to push to end. Stampede, Kyrie with the flank. A weird angle, an off angle to catch AP Brand off. The Purify gonna be used up by few. CW claims the orange buff. Keyboy gets out of the taunt. Lord spawning back in the land of Dawn, this time on AP Brand's side of the map.
Sorry, ada kesalahan teknis.
The defense for Onyx. Fortunately for them, they have all the tools to defend. They have an Eve. And this is something that they can use to bridge the early game to the mid game. At this time, Onyx needs to go full anti-disaster protocol now. They need to just regain their part of the map at least. Yeah. And they can use the E for that one.
Super Mario able to get the turret up top. Kyrie so far is taking the opportunity of AP Brand setting everything up for him to farm for himself, because he understands that he needs to get as tanky as possible.
Hold up, that turret. Ooh, still kept alive by Onyx. Now looking at the mid lane tier 1. Holding it down, but the turret should fall tier 1 over to AP Brand.
See that move coming out from Kaltizi, zoning out the members of Onyx by just literally walking down, and AP Brand are taking an easy turret in the middle, further increasing their lead to 4k, and of course they're gonna get another turret. Now Onyx, their base falls.
This is not looking good for Onyx. You can hear the cheers coming in. AP Brand has the energy coming in from the crowd. Boots goes in, Kyrie is
same, now taunted up. Parah misinya di sini ngeselin. Keyboy down. Aduh.
At the crowd, yeah. Everything went right, but the damage was not enough. Mid lane base turret at risk of getting taken down. One more shot.
What?
Two base turrets. 10 seconds on the clock for Keyboy. 6 for Boots.
Admirable coming out from Mark to go for the play. Because Boots landed a beautiful penalty zone, but they didn't have the damage. And Sans was sitting back. In fact, CW was babysitting Sans during that time, because he knows that the Khalid will eventually jump and they needed to punish. What that meant is that after the jump coming up from Boots, there wasn't any follow-up damage. even the real world manipulation is not enough because the Nether Realm is available. So Onyx tried to go for the play, didn't have the items to back it up, and unfortunately lost so much because of that gamble.
AP Brand now doing the Lord as Kyrie. One again.
Oh no.
Brought back and taken down. Onyx and the Brink. And AP Brand capitalized. Now onto Boots. DPC. Keep it with Oddity. With the Rough Waves. The Nether Realm saves him. CW with a Purify. AP Brand are running off.
He should have been Theramis.
There's no defense. Sans is down for 30 seconds. There's a fat minion of waves in the bottom lane, and they have the Brody.
Are they gonna end this?
Oh
no, the base! Oh, it's over.
Congrats, AP Brand.